see this problem. Yes, as following appeared on 1st April 2018, assets, rate of depreciation, and assets amount and rate of depreciation. Building 2 lakhs, the rate of depreciation is 5%, plant and machinery 3 lakhs, depreciation rate 15%, motor car 50,000, 15%, plant and machinery, the amount 4 lakhs, the rate of depreciation 30%, and furniture 50,000, rate of depreciation 10%. So totally, moving blocks of assets are there. Total block of assets, 1, 2, 3, 4. Plant and machinery 15%, motor car 15%. Belong to same class of assets. Block of assets means group of assets falling within the same class of assets. Same class of assets means plant and machinery depreciation rate 15%. Only the same rate of depreciation charged. During the year, he purchased the following assets. The date of purchase and assets, the amount. Date of purchase, 1st December 2018, building 4 lakhs. 30th September 2018, plant and machinery depreciated at 15%, amount of 1,50,000. And the following assets were sold during the period, plant and machinery rupees 1 lakh. Calculate the amount of depreciation. If the date of purchase is not given in the problem, then you have to assume that such assets are used for more than 180 days. Hence, you can charge full rate of depreciation. How to calculate the depreciation? The procedure for calculating depreciation, return on value, block of assets, total block of assets, for total block of assets, for building, plant and machinery 15%, plant and machinery 30%, and furniture 15%, 30%, and furniture 10%, building 5%. Return on value. At the beginning, return on value as on 1st April 2018. Building, first block, rupees 2 lakhs. Second block, 3 lakhs, 50,000. Third block, 4 lakhs. And furniture rupees 50,000. Next, add purchases during the previous year. Purchases during the previous year. During the year, the following assets were purchased by him. The date of purchase is given. Building, how much?
2
lakhs. And plant and machinery, 1 lakh 50,000. Nil. So the total value after adding the purchases, 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs, and 50,000. Less sales made during the year. The following assets were sold, that is plant and machinery. Plant and machinery rupees 1 lakh. Plant and machinery 1 lakh. So the remaining value, that is return on value before depreciation, building 4 lakh and the plant and machinery 4 lakh. Plant and machinery depreciated at 30%, 4 lakh and furniture 50. Now we should calculate the depreciation. The depreciation has to be calculated on the return on value before depreciation. First, rupees 4 lakhs. During year, no buildings were purchased. Hence, full rate of depreciation. 5 lakhs, sorry, 5% on 4 lakhs. Comes to rupees 20,000. Depreciation. Less depreciation. 4 lakhs, on which we should calculate the rate of depreciation 5% comes to 20,000. And see, the plant and machinery is chargeable, depreciated at 30%. Again, 4 lakhs opening balance, and there were no purchases during the previous year. Hence, the full rate of depreciation, that is 30% of 4 lakh, 1 lakh 20,000. And again, on furniture, opening balance 50,000, no purchases, no sales, hence the return on value before depreciation, full 50,000 worth of furniture were used in the business. Hence, the full rate of depreciation, that is 50%, only we should get 10% compulsory, 5,000. Now, the plant and depreciation on plant and machinery at 15%. Here, the return on value before depreciation is 4 lakhs. Out of these, 1 lakh worth of purchases, machinery was purchased during the year. Plant and machinery, 15%. How much? 1,50,000. 1,50,000. 1,50,000 is referred as new machinery, and the balance of it is 2,50,000 is referred as old machinery, and hence we have to calculate depreciation like this: normal depreciation and additional depreciation. If the plant and machinery purchased during the previous year, then we have to charge normal depreciation as well as additional depreciation, provided such plant and machinery should be used in the business for as manufacturing process. Such a machinery or plant should be used in the business for manufacturing. Sorry, usually as manufacturing process or usually manufacturing processes. 1,50,000 new machinery. 2,50,000 old machinery. Total depreciable plant and machinery is 4 lakh. How to calculate the date of purchase of plant and machinery on 30th November 2018? 30th November 2018. Hence, it was used in the business for more than 180 days. Hence, full rate of depreciation, normal depreciation on 1,50,000, normal depreciation is at 15%. So, 15% of 1,50,000, 22,500. And additional depreciation, as the asset was purchased during the previous year, which was used in the manufacturing process, you have to calculate additional depreciation at the rate of how much? 20%. If it is used for business for less than 180 days, then 10%, now 20%. So the additional depreciation, 20% of 1,50,000 comes from 30,000. Next, old machinery, the remaining balance, 2,50,000. On which we should calculate only the normal depreciation, not additional depreciation. So normal depreciation at the rate of 15% on 2,50,000 comes from 37,500. So the total depreciation, that is normal depreciation, comes to rupees 60,000. Normal depreciation 60,000 and additional depreciation 30,000. Hence the total depreciation on plant and machinery depreciable at 15% is 90,000. Normal depreciation plus additional depreciation. If you want the wrong additional day, purchase the building of rupees 2 lakh on 1st December 2018. Hence, total value of building rupees 4 lakh, out of which old building 2 lakh, new building 2 lakh. On new building, the rate of depreciation, though it is 5%, it was used in the business for less than 180 days, hence only 50% of normal rate of depreciation. Hence, the amount of depreciation on 2 lakhs, 2.5%, and the balance of 2 lakhs old building, 5%. Refer to that. 10,000 and 2.5 into 2 lakhs, 5,000. Lakhs into 2.5%, 5,000. So total depreciation on land and building rupees 15,000. Next, return on value after depreciation 3,85,000, 3,10,000, 2,80,000, and 45,000. 45,000. So this we have to calculate depreciation.